All right. Everybody get in today. I have a picture underneath my jelly plate that we had done from one of the fib paint alongs. And I was going to try to show how Devin kind of did her project. So I'm going to let everybody kind of get in the chat. I'm also going to pull it up on my phone so it's easier to see. Paste that if anyone else wants to play along. All right. Give me just a second. Hi, Lori. Hi, John. I have the giraffe out to do this way too, Lori, if we have time. Hi, Shauna. So I'm going to, like I said, that's just the print of the zebra underneath. And I'm going to start, it's reverse. So I got to think like painting on glass. I got to think backwards. So I'm going to start with just some text that I want to show up. I don't think I want a lot of it over here to show up because that's awful busy as it is. Right now, I don't even know where my black and my color is because I'm not looking at the photograph. All right. So that's that. So I'm going to let that sit. Hi, Dottie. All right. All right, I'm going to get some tape real quick. And I'm going to take the photograph. So I can see it. All right. The first thing I think I want to do is actually I'm going to use a little heavier opaque white. Hi, Judy. I took a debit card. And I'm going to use the debit card to kind of put in some of the hair. Probably should have cut it even a little smaller. It's not a debit card. It's a gift card, like a Subway card. That's what this one is. Okay, there's that ear. So anything I want on the top, what you would do last, this will make Dottie so happy. We're going to do the eyes early. Now I can add Posca at the end, but I'm trying to do as much as I can in the reverse. cut this. Hi, CB. A little smaller. Okay. Let's get highlight on the eye. All right, I think that's good for the eye part. And you look one way and you're right on the picture, and then you look another way. So you almost have to kind of keep your angle the same. I may have to come in, like I said, with the Posca and add more white. In there. Hi, Elaine. Okay, I think that's pretty good for the white part. This is the jelly plate, and my sketch is underneath. And I cleaned my jelly plate really good before I did this so that I would not have a lot of impurities. All right, so now I'm going to go to the black. And I also want to grab a brown real quick. For the eyes. Okay. that dry. That's going to be the pupil. Just put a little suggestion of the lashes in. But some of that may have to go be Posca too. Okay, so now I'm going to paint in the stripes. This will be the tedious part. And I'm trying to sort of pounce the paint in. Because I cleaned my plate, it's kind of wanting to bead up a little bit. So I'm going to have to come back and touch up. But I don't care if it's not solid. Where is our fearless leader today? I wonder if it using the StreamYard doesn't alter the notices somehow. I'm going to let those kind of dry and then come back because it's just pushing around. And I may have to vamp a little bit on it. Put some of that shadow in there. Helps to look at the computer too. Sorry, I'm quiet. Trying to make sure that I don't mess up this pattern. Hi, Kathy. When do you leave for London, Kathy? It's this week, right? Oh, cool. Hi, Janet. I wish I could fit in your suitcase. It's one of the places I would love to go, is the UK. London. Paris, Greece, those are probably my top. Well, in Australia, New Zealand area, those are my top places I would love to be able to go. Someday. Somebody's not getting along with somebody else out there. I'm sure you'll take lots of fabulous pictures of doors and architectural features, windows. I'm just going over bald spots. Where it's dried. Yeah, I mean, it kind of changed your our viewpoint of like what you could do yourself. I mean, almost had the idea that you could do some kind of digital exchange. That everybody could take photos in their own locations. And we could put them in a file, like at Best Group or someplace online, where everybody could have access to them and permission to use them. Kind of like a napkin exchange, but it would be digital photos. Because we all have our towns, all have unique places where we live. Styles of architecture. Okay, I think that's pretty good. There's a few places. Janet, yes, there is. There's gotta be. You've Lake. You have pretty mountains in your area. You live on the pretty side of Oklahoma. Okay, thanks, Joan. How do you know somebody could have a burning desire to have some red Oklahoma red dirt images? Okay. Now we need brown in the eyes. Thank you. Hey, what about camper, like vintage Airstreams, Janet? Cute little campers. I know, Elaine. I've been to Oklahoma City and I've been to East Oklahoma. That's why I said you live on the pretty part of Oklahoma. We went up the East Coast one time because we didn't want to drive through the red dirt area. All right, what I'm going to use for the colors is I'm going to use some of these Lumineers. Okay, so this is a blue gold. That's a definite. I don't think I want any pewter. And the halo violet gold is good. And the halo pink gold. We'll go with those right now. Well, you know those cute little vintage trailers? They're a Jacquard product. They're by the same people that make the pinata inks, Kathy. And I got an exciter set that had 9. All right, I'm going to use my little jelly plate and my little brayer. I think I'm going to start with the pink. They're real sheer. Oh, my brown eye just disappeared because it's too wet. Let me try something different real quick. Getting the Posca paint pen. That may be too wet too. Just needs to dry before I touch it. Now, Devin used alcohol markers. She used alcohol ink. Brown is beaten up. Okay. All right, and let's try some of the purple. A little heavier on that. Just let's get some of that blue in there. Hi, Terry. Okay, I do need a black line real quick. I need that to finish it. Okay. Back to the purple. Let's go back to the pink. That may even be a gold. Some of this isn't going to be on the paper, but all right, now I need to. I'm going to get that pink again. And blue gold. Let's put that here and there. All right, let's get some purple out there. Some green. I know. Looks like a hot mess right now. Hi, Devin. Okay, I think it's almost dry. The lid's all on those. Then I have white paint so we can do a cleanup print. Thanks, Devin. Thanks for the inspiration. I'm just going to leave the background white. And I don't care if it's a patchy white. I just want enough paint on there to pick it up. No, I'll tell this I don't need over here. Okay. Here's my cardstock. I wish I had bigger paper than cardstock. You know what? I'm going to pick it up on this that Kathy sent me. Because I don't want to not, I can always cut it out and use it. Because I don't know how I want to use it right now. I want it to dry really good. Hopefully, I'm going to ask Sherry if it doesn't work. It's Kathy's fault. I want to give it like, I'm hoping that I got enough of the white paint on there. To pick up all of the zebra. But if we have to, we could go back in and do some touch-ups. it's not your fault because of the paper. I just want a big enough piece of paper. And I'm going to let it sit there. The plate's coming pretty clean, y'all. I'm going to make sure this right in here. Wait for it. Wait for it. The big reveal is coming. I'm trying to pull slow. I don't want to. That is pretty cool. I mean, it just needs a little work here and there with like a black Posca. And can you see the shimmer? All right. It needs some work on the eyes, not a lot. And it needs some work around the mouth, some defining down here. And maybe some softening where the white was. Let's get it to a manageable size. All right, let's move the jelly plate. And my original is now greasy. I'm going to let the plate sit over here for a few minutes. And we'll get it back in just a minute. Okay, I feel like this needs to be minimized. So I'm going to get the little gel plate. What did I do? I'm gonna get the little gel plate back. And I want to soften pink and the purple. Because these are pretty sheer anyways. And let's go over the white. With the pink and the purple. And then I'm gonna get the little bit of the green. Okay, I think that kind of helped. And then the ears need a little defining. I think that works. And there's some places where the black didn't come in that I'm just going to put some sheer iridescent, unless we want to paint it black again. But I kind of like the messiness of it. Now it's about a black, the Posca pen. Get the eyes kind of back in. Where's the brown? Come back with the black. All right, and then a white highlight. And I think this one will be done. Okay, that sounds fun. Put the link I think I need more black here. Okay, that was fun. And I think that added the definition back in. It might need. This is the large jelly plate, the really big one. The 12 by 16, or it's the big gel press. Okay. My drawing graphite is on the back. I wonder if that can be picked up with paint. That's the graphite stuck to the back. Thanks, Dot. No, I traced. I used the photograph. There was no way. Okay, it's really light. It's really, really light. You probably can't see it on the camera. But I could definitely go back in and use like colored pencil or something and finish that. So I am going to use some hand sanitizer to get that off there. Maybe, maybe not. I hope. It seems like it's permanent. I should have turned my. Okay, so if anybody does this at home, turn your print over. I could have put the graphite on the other side, super easy, and made it face the other way. Let's try some baby oil. Well, that's getting it. I just had to put some, I needed more of a solvent. And I'm putting pressure in with the baby wipe. I'll do the giraffe this way next. But I'll put it pencil lead side down. Now I just used the photograph and got the high points that I needed. Okay, that's clean on that side. And that's clean on. Hi, Shelly. Okay, this is almost clean. We'll try the giraffe. Okay, but we'll put the giraffe backwards. Actually, I don't care if I get the pencil lead on there. It's going to be too hard to see. All right, Lori Lou, what color should we do the spots? You can use any paints. We don't have to use those paints. Should we keep the spots in the brown color? That was really wet. We'll let that. I'm not going to worry about the white highlight. I'll add it afterwards because they're not showing up. Okay, so we'll do the spots in brown, and then we'll do some other colors that are more wild, shimmery. Okay. I have this brown, but I think I'm going to get... Here's a burnt sienna. I want a little bit of an okra. Raw sienna. Yeah, I'm going to use raw sienna with a little burnt sienna. I don't know, this may not be any good. Oh, that paint's yuck. Yuck, yuck. But I have another one. I think I knew that. I ordered another one. I'll start with the lighter color. Because you definitely need more than one coat. Okay. And actually, these we want some colors besides the natural. Okay, let's come back in. Okay. I use some PBOs. I'm not sure. We can use the Lumen Hairs again. Could use alcohol inks. Clean that up a little bit. Yeah. We're just doing what we want to do. We're not going realistic. The spots are dark and the rest is light. But I'm not going to use realistic colors. I don't know what colors I'm going to use. I don't want to use the same ones we just used. I know that. Okay. That needs to dry. I have all kinds of metallics. Kind of thinking about that blue is pretty in areas, not all over. I really, really like this lime green color. Teal with the brown is good. So here's some teal and some lime green, and we could put some blue in some places. All right, so I'm going to use a brush right now. Gives me a little bit of an outline. Okay, and then I'm gonna try some like a magenta. I don't know how heavy this is gonna be. I might have to get a different That didn't do what I want, so let's try this. Let's put the rest of the pink over here, though, because some of it might show up. This is much heavier. My glass is back. That sent me up. Oh, Beth's live, I guess. I don't know. Oh, she's testing something, is all. Sorry. All right, get some more of that. This is going to be my main color. And then I'm going to put some stuff. It's sheer enough. Yeah, she's testing. I saw that. These aren't all dry, so I'm kind of. And that blue and some spots, just separate the. Get a little bit of both in the bottom. Okay, now we need another color. That's going to be heavy enough. I have a magenta. It's not sparkly. Let's try a little of that. In a few places. Okay. I think that'll be a good blend. They might be busy doing cleanup stuff. I'll put a little bit of pink behind some of these spots. Which will show up in some of those bald spots. Okay. Taking a little bit of that pink and that blue and making like a purple. Okay. Needs to be more turquoise in here. Palette's getting pretty dry. Okay, I think that's good. I'll leave that to the side. All right, we're gonna pick it up. It's white. Or a Titan buff. I think I want to pick it up with a Titan buff this time. All right, so that's a Titan buff. It's a little heavier body, so I'm going to put it to the side. Brayer. I'm going to get the same paper. Big enough. I'm not worried about if it's straight or not because I'll cut it down. I might tear the edges of the paper. I got to get stuff off the table. These little luminaires I took out of the, they need to find a home. I took them out of the alcohol ink because I bought more alcohol ink so they don't fit in there. Maybe a hideous mess. I may have to apologize to Lori. Might traumatize her. No. It's not coming up. It's too much paint, y'all. Though my giraffe is pretty much okay. Okay, very little my giraffe came up, which is a good thing. Look at that. I'll just leave that. That's an interesting piece to start on, something on. All right, let's let that dry. And I'm going to use different paint because that was too. The only thing I lost important was the eye over here, but I can put that back in. But I do have cream, so maybe we should use a color. Let's just use the white. Another piece of paper. Oh, that's not even on straight at all. I'm going to brayer this though. And really give it time to dry. Really apply some pressure. I'm not getting it all. I'm getting an interesting print. I might get two. It looks like I scribbled it with Crayolas. Okay, so that's interesting. We add the eyes back in and we come back in and maybe add some of the features. Let's try adding more paint. Take the back side of this paper. What you hear is the tracing paper underneath. Let me take that off. It's just getting wrinkled. This is going to be a wrinkled print. Should have done the dry end of the paper. It is finally getting most of the paint up. So again, it gives me a very watercolor-like giraffe that I could fill in the features. Let me cut this. Okay, let's flip the plate over because I do have a graphite drawing that I can try to lift. Some of it. Then we'll put the jelly plate away. I lost my phone. I could have. Okay, that came again. Y'all aren't going to see it on the camera, but it's real light. Real, real faint. And that definitely could be colored pencil, almost like a color book page. Or clear gesso put on top of it, and maybe even watercolor or ink tints. Like maybe ink tints would be cool. Let's try ink tints with that. Let's clean this off and put it away. Yeah, traumatized Lori. Lori, you want one of my little funky crafts to fix and repair? I'll be happy to send it to you. Huh? Yeah. Just so we can get a rise out of Eileen, right? Do you want me to send that little baby to you? And you can take some colored pencils to it or some markers. Here's this one. Speak. Is she traumatized? Looking for the zebra so I don't lose it. Oh, there it is.
Thank you, Lynn.
Throw that paper away. Don't need it, don't need it, don't need it. I have to keep telling myself. I'm gonna get that clean. The baby all work better, so I'll do that first. Yeah, I think the zebra turned out better. The problem may have been my paint was so heavy because I didn't brayer the paint on the giraffe. I painted it, which made it a much heavier application. But it would have been hard I should have brayered some of it. I think is part, it was too heavy of an application. All right. That's the bottom clean. Okay. Hey, Pat. Actually, Lori, I have your address. I think. Should still be in my Etsy. Tray. Put the top on the top. All right, let me put the jelly plate away. Let's get rid of the extra paper that we don't need. Using the paint to kind of guide me, just a rough cut. I'm not worried about it being square right now. Baby oil away. Yeah, I said, did you want one of the giraffes? One or two? One or two, if you want to play with it with colored pencils or markers or... I actually may send both of them to you. All right, we're going to ink tints because we know Eileen loves ink tints. Let's go. Willow's pretty good. So is bark. Let's go willow. I'm just going to go out on the outside. A much bolder line over here. We'll wick it out with the water. Okay, I need to look at my add some extra ones in there. Plan for some of that too, so. All right, so there's the first slider. This is just a little darker brown. Some variety in there. All right, let's get a watercolor brush. And I think I'm going to use turquoise with this. I'll get paper towel. Try to get everything the way you want it. Same with a new phone, right? Actually, I think I'm going to add some dark in here too. I need a different brush. If I don't have enough pigment, I can go back in and add pigment using the damp brush. I'm just going to put some pigment on the brush. Get it too wet. Okay. Could get my blocks out too. I like the dark on the outside. So I'll put more of that. Need more pigment on the inside. Read the phone where I can see it. Trying to use the stuff I have, like, I find that you get things and then you end up not using them. So I'm trying to find a way that I like using the products I bought. It's either that or I'm going to just need to move them out of my studio. Which one would assume that Eileen has got rid of her ink tints. Okay, so that's pretty good. Okay. Get these little spots. This is damp paper, so I'm trying to just get some more pigment in the areas. Okay. There's something over here I don't like, but I'm going to get rid of it later. There's a line. I just want to minimize it. on the ear. Okay. See, maybe this needs to be that. That's the problem. That's where it's. Get a little pilling and a little. Okay, now I need my other color. Let me see on my what I want. Green aquamarine. No, that's not what I want. Green aquamarine. Dark aquamarine and teal, I guess. I might need the blocks for some of this. Okay, it's too green. Thank you. Well, it's hard when you see your pets that way, isn't it, Vicky? And hi, by the way. Thank you. I think I'm going to come teal around all of the spots so I can go out lighter from them. Well, if he was scared, I mean, those are, that's your babies. This will make up for the other giraffe. Why do I keep saying graph? It's giraffe. Okay. Found some brown that's not colored in. Hi, Devin. I'll put a picture on Twitter and Instagram and all that. turn it so I can activate the blues, but sort of stay out of the browns. Okay. Switch brushes for some of this, because that little brush is too small for some of that area. Because this paper is not really heavy enough for watercolor, but I'm not giving it a whole lot of water. Switch back to a smaller brush again. Almost done. I'm gonna come under here because I feel like it needs. I get some more of that bright blue in places. Bit up here. She's blind. Actually, I don't want that color. I want. All right, I think other than ice, we're done. And maybe a background, which we can do with a block ink tints. Clean those. We'll try a background in a minute. Let's give them some ice. We can put in an eye. That's too wet. Just a second. Let's put these up and get the other box. Actually, I think I'll just use watercolor instead of the blocks for the yellow. It'll be easier. Thank you, Kathy. On the yellows there. Let them sit for a minute. We need black in this nostril too. Got just a little bit of white in there. We need a black back in here, just a little. A little bit of a eyelash in there. Okay. So I got the face in. Flat. You're going to see some of the texture of the paint from the jelly plate, which I actually like. And I'm using Azo Gold and a little nickel. Okay, I think I like that. I'm gonna add a little bit of new gamboge. I like this side lighter and I like this side darker. I think that's good. Huh, that's weird, Sophia. All right, other than signing it and giving her a name, I'm done. So let's clean up a little bit. Well, get pens. Okay, this is not the mat, this is a dirty mat, but let's. Mat it. And let's name her. After our Lori. Blue. There we go. I almost think she'd be pretty in a bronze colored mat. Don't you? I might take this one that's been dirtied. I'm leaning toward the bronze. So what I can do is, and I'll do this while Sean is on. I'm not gonna paint it all here. But I'm going to take coffee bean. And a brush. And I'll give it a layer of coffee bean. Maybe two. And then what I'll do is come back in with the bronze. Get just a little corner of it. Take Rich Espresso. But I have one of these open, but we use this one. I hate when these paints won't mix. Try this again. I have a mess on my hands now. It has a really pretty color. I don't know if you can see, and it shimmers. And then if we add it, back to the mat, I think it pops really well. All right, guys, I am going to end this broadcast, and Shauna's going to come on probably in a few minutes. I'm going to get something to eat.